Bones for locks. Bones to hold up the mailbox.
Bouquet of recycled flowers, and they're perennials.
This is the bone house. It looks like some kind of a hips.
Everywhere in the house, there's a lot of bone. And outside, there are some bone decorations, but most of it is inside. We've used bones for handles. I've used a lot of bone because I love bone. And the only difference between bone and ivory is that ivory is illegal and bone is free. This is a bone countertop. Those are rib bones cut in half, and the nose here are leg bones. Every rancher in Texas has a boneyard. I say, can I raid your boneyard? And they'll say, help yourself. Then we have bone struts. Then we have kind of a primal slam here on the staircase. We have on the treads, we have cross sections of bone. And then on the nose, we have slab cuts of bone. How do you learn how to work with bone? Well, there's no manual, so you just, it's trial and error.
And much like tile, put into place with thin set and grout.
The floor here is redwood. They're redwood shards.
That's fantastic.
You take what is known as a chop saw or a miter saw, and you make little wafers. Zing, zing, zing. You have to make that noise with your mouth. And you slam it with a hammer, and you have these shards, glue them down, grout it, and you have a wonderful mosaic floor. A little bone surprise is in here. Then in the kitchen, we have a pine shard floor, and the idea is that there are flames going up to a phoenix. The name of our company is the Phoenix Commotion, which is a metaphor of new life from old, of the legendary bird that flew into the fire and then rose out of the ashes to live again. This is the first bedroom. It's a three-bedroom, three-bath house with the idea that three artists could share the space because each had his own bathroom.
Yeah.
It's the first bedroom. And have a small bathroom here out of broken mirror shards. And if you don't feel good about yourself naked, you shouldn't be in this bathroom. But broken mirror is available by the metric ton. And of course, I have my crew break the mirror because that's 7 years bad luck. Then in here, we have a bottle cap floor. More steel goes into bottle caps than American automobiles annually. That steel is gone forever. The bathroom in here, we have a papier-mâché floor out of beer labels. And it's just third grade technique. You just glue it to the floor and urethane it. Then a lot of broken tile and wine bottle butts in mosaic in the bathroom. Walk on bones. And on the landing up here is a papier-mâché floor with grocery sacks. Once again, third grade technique.
It looks almost like stone or leather.
Almost, yeah. It's pretty amazing. Then in the second landing here, we have champagne corks. And then in the bedroom, we have wine corks.
You know, you really have to be able to drink a lot to build one of these houses, don't
yeah.
you?
This is the amazing clay man.
We had to heavily contribute to most
yes.
of the
Well, Clay, it looks like you contributed last night.
And you get bragging rights with wine corks. You can say that's the Chateau Petrus 1953.
Yes, or that's the party we had to celebrate yeah. the completion of the bone house.
Right. And then there's a little bathroom right across from the bedroom.
And this yeah. wide plank wood.
Yeah.
And the tile mosaic.
Down here we have patio furniture out of bone, and they're reasonably comfortable. They're not, be nice to maybe have a cushion once in a while.
I think they're very comfortable.
They're reasonably comfortable. These doors here are done by Josh Starkey and Linda Zaplack. Josh built the doors around some glass medicine cabinet shelves that I got. And then Linda put the stained glass on it. And these are all spinal processes. Some of them look like gargoyles here. I've always loved bone. And back when I was restoring art and antiques, finding ivory to repair ivory finials and snuff bottles and little statuettes was very difficult because it's illegal. And the only difference between bone and ivory is that bone is free. And not illegal.
and we have more piles of bones just waiting to be used.
It's meant for doing roast or pizza.
Just love the bones that are coming up out of that, and a bone handle. What do you do with the old Chevron sign in Texas? Well, you use it to make a party place.
The siding on the outside of this are cuts on the outside of the log from a sawmill that isn't large enough to exploit into dimensional lumber, so it makes dandy siding. This side of the wall are kill-dried 1x6, but they're all crowned, and they can't exploit those into dimensional lumber.
So you decided to use one of the techniques that you talk about frequently, repetition creates pattern. You made a waving pattern. You used wood that was warped and would have been thrown away, created a waving pattern to make it look in harmony.
What's really wonderful about this is that the design grows out of the materials that are available. This otherwise would have been mulch. Since this is a studio residence combination, we have a studio in here. And the university gave me 15,000 DVDs, so we put those on the wall.
CDs are a relatively free resource. You can get them by the bundle, so they are great to be used as a wall covering and a ceiling covering.
All this mirror represents 2 hours of waste at a local glass company. That's how much mirror they throw away every 2 hours. The bathroom and washer dryer is upstairs here. We have a papier-mâché floor in here, done by Edie Wells.
So it's sheet music.
Yeah. And then a lot of vinyl on the ceiling, and then CDs on the ceiling as well, which makes a dandy ceiling covering. This chandelier represents everything I hate about American vanity, kind of a Catherine de' Medici wannabe. I got one of those, and we replaced the missing drops with hog ribs. It's kind of a jab in that direction.
Really fantastic stuff. Why not just use a resource that we have that's renewable and unlimited, cattle bones? Here's me.